Step 1, you get some harmless-looking PDF reader from Google Play. Step 2, get infected with malware. Step 3, before you run to get an antivirus for Android or jump ship to the iPhone land, let's dissect this Google Play and Android malware issue. You'd think there's a good security system in place to catch this stuff, right? Well, there is, and there isn't. Say I make an app. To get it on Google Play Store, it first needs to go through a verification process. There's a cloud-based security scan that analyzes the app's code, as well as a built-in security system called Play Protect, which continuously checks apps for malicious behavior. Then there are manual reviews. A team of specialists check if the app complies with Google Play's developer policy. No spam, no malware, no privacy violations, you know, all that good stuff. If my app was related to sensitive information, like health information or finance information, then the review process would be even more rigorous. But my hypothetical app obviously has no hypothetical issues, so it passes the test. Hypothetically. But so did the Anatsa Trojan. This piece of nasty snuck into the Google Play Store, disguising itself under multiple harmless-looking apps such as PDF readers and phone cleaners, and no amount of scans and reviews were able to catch it. How did that happen? Once installed, Anatsa requested permissions that seemed reasonable, but ultimately allowed Anatsa malware to wreak complete havoc on the infected device. It recorded credit card info, stole login credentials, altered transactions and redirected funds, basically made Play Store security look like a joke. Apart from the Google Play Store malware concerns, this inevitably raised the never-ending Android versus iPhone security debate. And sure, let's entertain this idea for a second, shall we? For one, getting an app to appear on the App Store is a much harder process than it is with Google Play. Plus, unlike iOS, Android is open source and allows a bit of variety. While that's a plus for many, it also makes it much harder to control Android security overall. So if there are holes, an antivirus for Android is beginning to sound like a good patch, right? Well, yeah, but first, Android virus protection has to start with good security practices. No, there's no safer alternative to Google Play, not yet at least. But you can and always should double check stuff, read reviews, Google the app's name, and stick to well-known providers to get the tools you need. The same thing applies to downloading stuff from suspicious websites or opening attachments from unknown senders. If you get an app, pay attention to what permissions it wants. I mean, a PDF reader, for example, probably doesn't need access to your contacts, right? Does it? So, there you go. Also, make sure to update the apps that you use and regularly delete the ones you don't need anymore. Only then can we talk about taking Android security a step further. If you're worried you already caught something or just want overall peace of mind, then getting an Android antivirus is the most straightforward solution. A simple Android virus scan should reveal any problematic apps you have on your phone, as well as potential vulnerabilities. I use Bitdefender. Oldie but goldie, mainly because it sorted out my malware issues once before. I swear, I've been careful ever since. If you want to learn more about it, I'll leave a link to their page in the description. Just an FYI, it's got a 14-day free trial. You can look into some other options too, like Sophos, Intercept X, or the ESET antivirus app. Each of these is a little bit different, but they all deal with malware really well. Is an antivirus gonna solve all your troubles? Nah, not necessarily. You still need to be aware of the online dangers and don't blindly trust apps you download. But it's a great safety net to have, especially since malicious apps keep evolving. A good antivirus is going to keep you safe without much effort on your part, so yes, I do recommend it. Just like I recommend subscribing to my channel. All right, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.